When the violence causes silence, we must be mistaken in such a strong kind of like stance. It's again, she's talking about fear. Fear of the IRA. And the mistaken. Like, are you kidding me? Are you serious? Maybe a couple of us need to put our lives on the line. Let's get these people to stop.
What I really should have said was that you and I are the only ones left. Everything here went to hell and people turned into these things.
What up, though, y'all? Shouts out to all my lemonheads out there in YouTube land. Appreciate y'all. Know y'all the fam. Know you the fam, baby. Yeah. All right, man. On today's episode, y'all. Look, man, we're breaking into it. From the little bit of research I seen, the song means a little bit to old girl. Something about the IRA. Two kids died. Something like that. I believe the article said it was a bombing where two kids died over in, I think it was Ireland. I could be wrong about that. But yeah, you know what it is. Y'all seen the title, man. Yeah. Y'all know what's up. It's the Cranberries with Zombies, baby.
Oh, fuck yeah. This is the shit.
That's right, man. Hey, look, I just want to let y'all know, yes, I've heard the song. There's a lot of new subs here. So they might not know the story. So back in the day, I was nothing but hip-hop. And I mean nothing. Anything, like as soon as they come on the radio or MTV or whatnot, bloop, nah. Nah. Wanted nothing to do with it. Very close-minded. But at my gray old age that I am right now,
step off, Grandpa.
I kind of want to have an open mind to all kinds of music. That's what the channel's about. That's what we do here. So let's jump into it. We're going to do a brand new Whodunit series. That's right. Yep. This is going to be Who Did It Better. We got the Cranberries and their original writer. And then we got Bad Wolves with their rendition of it. Now, I don't know. I ain't heard the Bad Wolves version. All I got to say is this means a little something to old girl. This means a little something. Let's go ahead and break into it. Link to the original videos will be in the description below, guys. Let's kill it.
Well, any fucking time, sweetheart.
It's more dark than I remember it. I ain't heard this song in shit. Probably 15, 20 years. Yeah, it's a lot more dark than I remember it. Another head hangs lowly, another child is slowly taken.
You, an average human, can read?
That's tough, man. That's tough, dude.
It's not me, it's not
me.
Oh, good.
If you
grief.
See it's not my family. Huh, hold up.
Such silence, who are we mistaken? But you see, it's not me, it's not my family in your head.
I think she's talking about like how most people choose to deal with those situations. And, you know, a lot of them are just glad that it's not their family. It's not, you know, them. Or it could be like, they're like, hey, man, it wasn't me. It wasn't my family. Out of fear for, you know, the guys who caused it. Obviously, those guys were a huge, huge part of Ireland over there. I think they were like, bigger than the army for a minute. I could be wrong, but I think that's how it went. So that might be what it is.
You see, it's not me, it's not my family. In your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs.
Okay.
And their guns in your head.
With their bombs and their bomb butts.
In your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns.
With their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns. Okay, hey. Hey, homegirl's up here with it. Homegirl is, yeah, you can, it. She's like grinding her jaw while she's singing. Kind of puts that, like, grit out, like, ugh. You can tell she feeling what the fuck she talking about.
With their tanks and their bombs and their guns in your head, they are crying. In your head, zombie, zombie, zombie.
Another mother's breaking heart is taken over. Woo! This is some strong lyrics, boy.
Heart is taken over. When the violence causes silence, we must be mistaken.
So see, here's the thing. And I know she said that in the first one, too. She says, when the violence causes silence, we must be mistaken. So, it's again, she's talking about fear. Fear of the IRA. It's just, she's saying it in such a strong kind of like stance with how she's saying it. Like, and the mistaken, like, are you kidding me? Are you serious? Maybe a couple of us need to put our lives on the line. Let's get these fucking people to stop.
Silence causes silence. We must be mistaken.
Go, girl.
It's the same old teen since 1916 in your head.
Yeah. It's the same old theme since 1916. Guys, I don't know if that's like a thing between the IRA and Ireland.
You big dummy.
Or if that's just a war thing. because since, like, nuclear weapons and everything has been found, and I know that was after 1916, but countries like China and Israel and America and Russia have, we've been in this arms race, and it just keeps growing and growing and growing, and they have the weapons to completely eradicate us from the planet.
You got kind of a dark side, don't you?
And that shouldn't be the case. Sorry.
OT since 1916.
I don't know, but at least the last minute, man, they ain't been saying shit, and I feel it just as much as I did as when she was singing. Straight up, man, this is a very powerful song. So just off of that, like, okay, I will say this. Yes, I've heard the song more than I thought I did. I thought it was a different song.
Sure.
Yes, I've heard that song a little bit. I used to cut grass. This song was all over 89X. So, yeah, I've heard it a few times, but still never really crossed my mind. I mean, when you're riding in the truck with, you know, 2, 3, 4 other dudes, you got to listen to some stuff that they want to listen to, too. So that is where I kind of caught this. Very powerful. Very powerful from her voice to the riff. And the drums, I found, were really calling to me. The drums were almost like explosions of their own.
Calm down, bitch.
I don't know. Maybe I'm just dumb as hell. But, yeah, very powerful. Very kind of take a stance-ish, very protesty, you know, kind of, yeah. But either way, you could tell that this entire band felt like they were doing the right thing with this song. And I agree with you, girl. I agree with you and the band. Kick it. Kick your shit. All right, let's go ahead, break into the other one, man. That's going to be hard to beat, man. Originals usually are.
Man, I wish this motherfucker would hurry up.
All right, again, link to the original video is going to be in the description, y'all. Let's see who done it better.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, damn. So she was supposed to come through.
Will you shut up?
Oh, man. Oh, shit. So who knows, man? This could be just as powerful. I mean, you know, they're kicking it for some, you know, they're feeling what they're feeling too, man. Oh, he changed it. He said they're bombs and they're bombs and they're drones. Okay, dude. So far, I mean, we have about over a minute in, and this one is much more eerie feeling. Like it's more like scary movie-ish. That too. It's the same old theme in 2018. Come on. For real, when are we gonna get over this shit?
For realsies?
Like, for real, man. I know that people and you know, like, war is always gonna be a part of humanity. But damn, man, the silliness, man. The silliness. I will also say the heaviness is redonkulous on this one, dude. They're still fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their guns and their drones. In your head, they are dying. What's in your head? In your head. Stop it. Stop it, stop it, yeah, yeah. What's in your head? so much heavier, man. You see my fat ass? Just knock this chair down, boy. Damn, fat boy.
7 hours later.
Damn, man, I'm just too fat, I guess. I'm just too fat.
Oh, you're starting to piss me off, you little piglet son of a bitch.
That was fantabulous!
Her lyrics, confronting the collateral damage of political unrest, captured the same sentiment we wanted to express a quarter century later. That is a testament to the kind of enduring artist Dolores was and will remain forever. Good deal, my brother. Good deal. So, yeah, basically, man, that's going to be a tough one to judge, guys. I mean, you got the true nature of the first one, and obviously it is a straight banger. A smash. Like, that was better than what I remembered it as. And then,
for Christ's sake, spit it out.
I mean, you come in with the second one, they kind of matched the intensity. They brought a solo into it. The drums weren't as pronounced as they were in the first one. But that's tough, dude. That's rough, man. The music was great on both. I think her vocals were better, but his vocals went with their version of the song better. It's tough. I mean, he changed a couple of the lyrics, which made the song their own. Guys, I think they both did it great. I don't think this is going to be a whodunit better. They both did them great. I'm going to have to give both of those songs...
Don't you dare.
8.75.
Oh, you motherfuckers.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I mean, the intensity, the realness, the feeling, the instrumentation, the artistry. They were there in both of them. Those are both keepers in the banger list, baby. Both of them are keepers, y'all. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Y'all want to hear more Cranberries? You want to hear more Bad Wolves? Go ahead, like the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down there and let your homeboy know what you want to hear, who you want to hear it by. Say, Brother Maine, you got to kick it for me. Come on now. We're doing this all day, y'all. We're keeping open minds to music, past and present. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to dead this video right here, y'all. That was some straight heat. It's your boy, J-Money, out.
You're an evil child. Why did I have to go and smoke pot when I was pregnant with you?